1,000 miles per hour on a 5 mile per hour road, man. What's wrong with you? You going too quick, man. Look at this badge. Hey, you going to jail, bro. Man, get yourself back in jail, bro. Yeah, kiss your sister.
This is a video that we received this morning regarding our high-speed chase.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Michelle Trott, and I'm your Newton specialist.
I'm Ann Pham, and I'm your energy and forces specialist.
I'm Angela Nguyen, and I am your speed, velocity, and acceleration specialist.
So you might be wondering, why is a Newton specialist here to talk about the high-speed chase? Well, actually, the high-speed chase was very closely related to the first Newton's law, the second Newton's law, and the third Newton's law. So let's go ahead and go over that. So Newton's first law states that an object will not change its motion unless acted upon an unbalanced force. So if we watch this video right here of a prototype of the car, we can see that at first the car is not in motion and then it goes into motion. So we will rewatch that. As you can see, the car is not moving, but once an unbalanced force is acted upon it, it moves forward. All right, so next, the second Newton's law states that the acceleration of an object is related to the net force and inversely related to its mass. This pretty much means that depending on how heavy the object is, the heavier it is, the less speed, like it will not move as fast as a lighter object. So here is an example right here. So in this video, we can see that we have two different objects. Well, we have the prototype of the car as well as a heavier object. And when they were pushed at the same amount of force, we can see that the car moves faster just because the car is lighter than the candle. So I'll replay that for us. So both were pushed at the same amount of force, but we can see that the car moves faster than the candle. And then here is another angle. We can see that the speed of the car was faster than the candle, again, just because of the differences in mass. So Newton's third law states that for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. So if we watch this video right here, we can see that the water bottle hitting onto the mousetrap acts as an action force. And then the reaction force is that the mousetrap unwinds itself, pulling back the lever, which starts to unravel the already winded up string that we see in the back of the car. So I will replay that for us to see. So again, hitting the mousetrap acts as the action force, and then it moving forward is the reaction force.
Moving on, aside from Newton's laws, there are also a lot of energy stored in this car, which causes it to move very fast. As you can see, there's a lot of tension in the string right now because it is wind up, which is a part of potential energy. And as the string is unwinding, the car starts moving, as you can see here. That is a part of kinetic energy. It is mechanical energy. And also, because of the mechanical energy moving on the wooden floor, it is an energy transfer that creates sound waves for our ears to hear, which would be considered sound energy. Aside from studying the energy within the car, I also studied a lot of the forces that are acting upon the car as it was moving. Well, balanced forces are acting on the car when it is still, as shown in this mugshot of the convict. You can see that gravity is acting upon the force holding it down to Earth, while support force is pushing it up so it will not be destroyed by gravity. But in order for these to be balanced forces, they would have to be pushing at about the same newtons. So for example, if gravity is pushing down as about 50 newtons, support force would also have to be pushing up at 50 newtons. That is an example of balanced forces. But unbalanced forces could cause an object to slow down, speed up, or change direction. So as the car is moving, for example, air resistance could cause it to slow down. Like when we were chasing this car earlier, as it went, it had to slowly slow down, and the air resistance would be pushing one way while the car is moving the opposite way. So the air resistance would have to push at more newtons than the car for it to slow down.
So the average speed is distance divided by time, and the speed of the car is about 1 meter per second. Velocity is speed in a given direction, and the velocity of the car is going straight. The acceleration is change in velocity divided by time, and the acceleration of the car is 5.47 meters per second squared. And friction is the resistance that one surface or object encounters when moving over another. And depending on how much friction there is, it can either make the car slow down or speed up. A car traveling on a smooth floor will have a faster speed than a car traveling on concrete or grass because it has less friction.
I'm glad that he's off the roads now.
Yeah, he's too dangerous to be out there.
Oh, I think there's live footage of him entering jail right now. Let's cut to it.